If you are listening to this right now, I just wanted to tell you, thank you. Whether we have personally connected, whether we haven't personally connected, whatever industry you're in, if you're an entrepreneur, if you're a musician, if you're an artist, if your state of art is underwater basket weaving, whatever it might be, I don't care. You are appreciated because you're listening to this episode. You're now listening to episode 16 of the Hustler's Choice podcast, and I know for a fact that you're going to enjoy it. In today's episode, I discuss how you can bounce back from a loss and then some ways that you can prevent yourself from getting trapped in that same exact cycle and having things happen over and over again. I know that you're going to enjoy it. So with that being said, I'm going to be quiet and let you get to listening. And make sure to listen all the way through. You know, it's all love. So I'll see you on the other side. Yo, what is going on, everyone? Isaac Mashman here, and you are now listening to episode 16 of the Hustler's Choice podcast, the podcast that's goal is to get you to take your hustle, your life, and your business to unprecedented levels. And today, we are going to be talking about the topic and the subject of bouncing back from a low point. Now, whether or not you want to admit it, I am certain that you have had a time in your life to where you've just felt so depressed. You felt low. You were like, you know, my dream is starting to fade away from me. I'm not exactly sure what I'm doing. I lost the momentum in my business. Whatever it might have been, it's not an easy conversation to have with yourself, to have with other people. And it's not an easy thing to accept. But face it, guys, we are only human. We are in the process known as life. And for all of us entrepreneurs and for all of you musicians and rappers and artists and people who, you know, want more out of life, you know, who want to have the lifestyle of success, who want to have the lifestyle of, you know, going out and ordering off the right side of the menu versus the left, going into the store and not purchasing things off of the price tag. You know, for those of you who want to go travel, you know, and you want to see the rest of the world, you want to see what's, you know, what's out there to be discovered. You can't do that without momentum, and you can't do that without really, really pushing for your dream and pushing for those desires. And you know, I know that it is a struggle, you know, it is a struggle sometimes to maintain that focus, to maintain that, you know, drive when, you know, you're just feeling down. You know, there are certain days where, you know, you might get up in the morning and you might be like, I really don't even want to get up. You know, I just want to stay in bed. There are going to be some days where you get up and you feel better than others. You know, it's a process, but it's about finding that consistency that really, really matters. You know, being consistent in your actions and being consistent in, you know, your purpose and your reason why you're even working in the first place. And, you know, one of the easiest things that I can say to do, you know, if you're looking to reestablish that momentum and reestablish what you're doing, is not to overthink it. Over the past couple of months, you know, I've taken a lot of time for myself. I've, you know, been in this process of ups and downs and ups and downs and ups and downs, and it's almost felt like a cycle, and it's been super, super annoying. It's been difficult to go through. It's been depressing. Mentally, it's been a struggle. But the one thing that I keep reminding myself is the only way that this is ever going to change, the only way that my life will ever change, my situation will change, is if I put in the work, don't overthink it, and just get going. Get going, you know? I feel like procrastination and overthinking it, you know, overthinking life in general is the one thing that will really hinder most people from ever achieving success, from ever seeing success. And it's unfortunate, because it's something that isn't necessarily easy to overcome, but easy to identify. You know, when it comes to overcoming something, it takes time, it takes effort, it takes focus, and it takes self-awareness. You know, you can have the self-awareness, you can have all the self-awareness in the world to understand why you're not getting the results, but it takes willpower and it actually takes sheer focus for you to actually follow that self-awareness up with action, which will then result into change. I want you to go ahead and replay that past 30 seconds, you know, one more time to get, you know, a really clear view of what I just said. And guys, you know, how do you bounce back? How do you go from momentum to not having momentum to getting momentum again? And how do you prevent, you know, the drop off from happening again in the future? It's called work. It is honestly called work and consistency. It's called dedication. It's called being firm in your decisions. You know, Napoleon Hill, the author of Think and Grow Rich, if you haven't read that, I don't even know why you're listening to my podcast. Definitely go grab Think and Grow Rich by Napoleon Hill. But he has a chapter in there called Decisions, and it is one of the longest chapters, if not the longest chapter in that entire book. And he talks and discusses about how people of success, men of success, come to decisions quickly, and they very rarely, if ever, change their decision. And when I first heard that information, it went right over my head. I thought that whenever he was talking about decisions, he was actually referencing, you know, having, you know, deciding to go and pursue a certain, you know, occupation and deciding, you know, who you're wanting to stay with, or just on a much long-term scale. Like, I was thinking way too big in this specific scenario. You know, normally it's really good to think big, but in this case, it's more so thinking small that will do and achieve, you know, help you achieve those results that you want. And what he speaks about is maintaining your promises to yourself. If you say that you're going to do something, do it. You know, if you say that you're going to fast for 16 hours and then have a window of 8 hours of eating, you know, intermittent fasting, maintain that commitment to yourself. If you say you're going to do it, actually do it. If you say that you're going to get up at 5 o'clock in the morning and go work out, you maintain that commitment to yourself and you get up the next day at 5 o'clock and you go out and work out. Now, saying and promising is much different than actually doing. And this has been one of the big issues that I've had in my life that I've really been combating and really trying to overcome, is maintaining those promises, those self-promises. You know, it's one thing to maintain a promise to another person, but when it comes to maintaining the promises to yourself, we need to treat those just as if we made a promise to another person and another individual, right? Because you're afraid of what the other person might think of you if you don't maintain that promise, or if you don't keep your word, right? You're trying to establish a reputation. Well, it's the same exact thing with yourself. Maintaining the promises made to self, maintaining your own reputation in your own mind, because you see, consciously, it might not seem like a big deal. You know, you might be like, you know, one slip up might not be too big of a deal. You know, if I sleep in today, if I have that cheat meal, you know, it's cool. Big deal. Wrong. Because what happens over a period of time is your conscious mind starts to establish a pattern in your subconscious mind to where you get used to doing something the wrong way. You get used to breaking those promises. And once that habit is established and once that paradigm is established in your mind, then you have to spend a whole bunch of time breaking that. And in the end, you're just going to be repeating those same exact things that you were trying to avoid or you were trying to change in the first place. And it's just going to be a repetition until you finally break that cycle and you maintain those commitments. And so the best way to, you know, establish that willpower and to be building yourself back up is keeping the small promises you make to yourself. So start with something small. Say that you are getting up right now to do the dishes. As soon as you have that thought, don't overthink it, don't procrastinate, but get up and go do the dishes. If you say that you need to do laundry or you need to fold clothes, right? I imagine that almost all of you have that one chair in your room to where all your clothes go and get laid on that. That's kind of a negative thing to have in your life because it shows that you're unorganized and that you're not actually doing things when you need to be doing them, right? That something else in your life became an idol over the thing that you needed to do. That's called procrastination. You know, and procrastination is just the... It honestly makes no sense why we procrastinate in the first place, because we're hindering ourselves and holding us back from having the potential that we really, or from performing and acting with the potential that we have. Procrastination in of itself is one of the worst things you could ever do and one of the worst habits you could ever establish, because it affects every area of your life when it comes to relationships, when it comes to business, when it comes to, you know, friendships, when it comes to whatever it is. Procrastination can affect it. And so don't let that habit get established. Guys, you know, there are going to be multiple periods in life to where, you know, we have a lot of momentum and then we fall off. And it's not about those times that we go through. You know, we learn from those experiences, obviously, you know, but we don't understand what we're going to learn until, you know, months down the road or days later when you look back and you're like, oh, okay, so this is what I learned that I should do or that I shouldn't do, and this is how I do it differently for the next time, or this is how I prevent it from happening altogether. That's just a part of life, you know. It's going to be a cycle. It's going to be a cycle, but it's about becoming better and actually breaking through that cycle that is important. And guys, don't be so held back and focused on yesterday and focused on the things that you didn't accomplish that you feel overwhelmed and you beat yourself up and you just get in the wrong energy. You get in the wrong state of mind by focusing too much on yesterday, right? We can't change what we didn't do. We can't change what we did. We can't change yesterday. What we can do is we can influence today. We can determine what we do today that will influence our tomorrow and really shape our lives into what we want out of life. You know, every person's definition of success is different, but ultimately it has to do with potential. It has to do with pursuing dreams. It has to do with pursuing and becoming the person, the individual, the father, the mentor, the brother, the son, whatever it might be, that we've always wanted to become. every single person who's listening to this has that potential, has that capability of becoming that individual. It's about controlling yourself, controlling your mind, and controlling your willpower that will result in you actually becoming that person you want to become. I know that you have it in you guys. You know, it's the process isn't easy, but big deal, we can overcome that and we're stronger because of it. So guys, keep focused, keep your eyes forward, and keep hustling, and always remember, success before rest. You have just finished listening to episode 16 of the Hustler's Choice podcast. If you like this episode, make sure to share it with a friend and follow me on social media at Isaac Mashman, and go to isaacmashman.com. And with that being said, guys, keep crushing it, and talk soon.